Our today's topic is telescope. Telescope is again an optical device and it is used to see the objects which are at a distance. At a distance means if we want to see the star, moon, planets, the objects at such a large distance that can be seen through this device. There are very complicated telescopes made nowadays. What we will study is simply the principle of telescope, and that is a very simple telescope. It is made with the combination of two lenses. Both are convex lenses and they are fitted in a tube. There is a long tube, one convex lens here, one convex lens here. This one convex lens we place towards the object, so its name is objective lens. This is towards the eyes, so its name is eyepiece. So this is eyepiece and this is objective. Now when we observe the things which are far off, the rays from that object are coming to the objective lens. And all of them, because they are parallel, they concentrate and intersect at a single point. Is that focus? The answer is, we have defined focus as a point on the principal axis. But here, what we see, the object is very large. And just to calculate the angle, we assume that object is so large that the rays are coming at certain angle from there. If this is the object, here is our eyes, the rays will come like this. So the rays are making certain angles. So we assume that this is that angle made by the rays coming from the object, and they make a certain angle on our eyes, and that angle is this. So we give it a name, and the name of this angle is alpha. The measurement of this angle is alpha. This is made by object. Now, because they are parallel, they will meet at a point which is on the focal plane. This point is known as focus point, but this plane, if we make a plane here, then that will be known as focal plane. If the incoming rays are parallel to the principal axis. This is principal axis of a lens. If the rays are all parallel to principal axis, then after refraction, they meet at this point, and this point is focus. This we have studied. Now, if all these rays, I bend it like this, I put a torch and send all the rays which are in this direction, then these rays will meet at this point. If I bend all the rays this way, then these rays will meet at this point, here and here. All these points are in one plane, and this plane is known as focal plane. So if they are parallel, their point of intersection will be on the focal plane. If they are parallel and parallel to principal axis, then they will be meeting at a point which is on the focus, and that is on the principal axis. So here they are coming at an angle, so they will meet at a point which is just straight line perpendicular to the focus, and this is on the focal plane. Okay, so this is focus and focus of objective, this distance. Now what happens after this? This makes image. So this is the image we are able to make with help of one spherical lens, convex lens. Now this image is quite short and we want to magnify it further. The object of the first objective lens is to create an image. So it will create an image here. Now we want to study that image, and to study it, I want that this should be large. So for making it large, I use a simple microscope, and that is a magnifying glass. So this magnifying glass I place here, and here I put my eyes and see this object magnified. If I want to see this object magnified, there are two types of setting. One is at the distinct vision, we have studied about that, and one is for relaxed eyes. For the distinct vision, its magnification is 1 plus d upon f, and for parallel ray setting, this is d upon f only. So these are measurements of magnification of this simple microscope. Here we are calling it eyepiece because it is close to the eyes. So this is magnified, and we see the magnified picture of this image, and this is the image of certain planet or star which is on this side. So this is the action in telescope. You can ask whether really the image has been magnified. Yes, because when you see the star without any instrument, you see it just like a point. And when you see it in the telescope, it is much larger. Even if it has become like this, compared to a point, this is very large. This is magnification done by telescope. Is there any physical proof that this will really become large? Answer is yes. The angle subtended by the object is alpha. Object in the infinity is very large. These are the rays coming from the top end, from bottom end. So this is alpha, is the angle made by the object we assume. Then this ray which is coming from the bottom of that object, this is from top of that object, and that object in the sky is somewhere like this, far away from the top, from the bottom. This is direction from the bottom, and this is alpha. This is angle made at the eye. You can say eyes are here, how this is the angle? The answer is, these rays are coming from thousands of miles, millions of miles away. For them, this distance or this distance doesn't matter. So whether they make angle alpha here, they will make the same angle alpha here, they will make the same angle alpha on our eyes. So this can be treated as angle alpha made by the object on our instrument, on our eyes. Okay, now what is the angle made by the same image on our eyes? Answer, this ray is common, straight, coming from the bottom of the object, and this is the ray which is going to my eyes. Then this is the angle subtended by image on the eyes, and let's call it beta. Okay, now if beta is larger than alpha, then this is magnification, and we can see beta is larger than alpha. How beta is larger than alpha? Because this FO, and how much is this distance? This is also focal length of this. That is why the rays going from here have become parallel. So this has to be at the focus of this. So this is focal length of eyepiece. The focal length of eyepiece we take small, the focal length of object we take large. So beta upon alpha, this is alpha, so this is also alpha. So what is magnification in this case? I write it here, for this is setting for relaxed eyes, or eyes set for parallel rays. Now the magnification is equal to angle subtended by image on the eyes divided by angle subtended by object on the eyes. Here it is beta upon alpha, and for small angles we can take them as tangent. Tangent beta upon tangent alpha. Now tangent beta we take it as c to b dash upon a dash b dash. Sorry, a dash b dash upon b dash c2. A dash b dash upon base b dash c2. This is tangent beta. This is to be divided by tangent alpha. This is alpha, opposite angle, this is alpha, and its tangent is a dash b dash upon b dash c1. Cancellation of a dash b dash, and what we get is b dash c1 upon b dash c2. Now b dash c1, b dash c1, this is focal length of objective and the sign is positive on this side. So while putting the value, this is f0. B dash c2, b dash c2 is focal length of eyepiece, but it is on the left side, on the opposite side of incoming rays. So this is negative Fe. So we got the formula here. This is minus FO upon Fe. What is that? Magnification. Now if we have taken FO as large one and Fe as small one, definitely there is a magnification of more than one. So this is how we magnify with help of a telescope. Now in this telescope there are few features. We understand one thing, that FO should be larger than FE. FE should be as small as possible, FO should be as large as possible. If we take FO very 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 large, then is there any problem? Answer is yes. We have to use a very long pipe. And there is a limit of the long pipe. You can use 1 meter pipe, 2 meter pipe, not more than that. Other thing is that these rays, when these are magnified here, say we magnify it 20 times, then the brightness will decrease by 20 times, because the same rays, we are not increasing the number of rays. Initially when we see the star, it is giving certain brightness because all the 100 rays are in this area. Now when we magnify it, the image becomes this large, but the rays remain 100. So their density will become less and they will appear darker. So when we see the star, it's bright, but when we see it in the telescope, it becomes a bit darker because we see it larger. Now to make this effect less, we want to see brighter and brighter image. What should we do? Answer is, we should collect more and more rays, so that even in such a ray, the rays which are coming are 100, we want to make it 1000, so that when we magnify it, the intensity does not fall. So what do we do? This area we increase. Suppose we have this much of lens and it is collecting 1, 2, 3 rays. Now we have this much of lens and this lens is collecting a large number of rays. Suppose it can now collect this much. So here what we find, that there is a collection which is double than the previous collection. So its brightness has increased twice. Now if I increase this area 100 times, then the total rays will also increase 100 times. Then this image will be very very bright, and even if I see it larger, magnified, the intensity will not decrease much and I will be able to see it. So with this we understand one characteristic of telescope, that objective of the telescope should have as large aperture as possible. So that is why this lens is large aperture, For this, it should only accommodate our eyes and its focal length should be small. For small focal length, we cannot make very small, we cannot make very large apertures. We have to make the aperture small. So this is a smaller lens, this is a larger lens, and this is magnification. Now, in this magnification, we understand this. Can you compare it with magnification of microscope? Microscope is also made by the combination of two convex lenses, but in case of microscope, that is compound microscope, we have seen that magnification is something upon FO into FE. Both of these are in denominators. Here only this is in denominator, this is in numerator. So magnification of microscope, FO should be as small as possible. In telescope, magnification, FO should be as large as possible. This is the basic difference in telescope and microscope. So if somebody asks you why telescopes are long and microscopes are small, the answer is, in telescope we have to accommodate inside the focal length of objective lens, and the focal length of objective length has to be kept larger. That is why we have to make the pipe very long, and that is why the telescopes are very long pipe machines. So this is about the telescope. Now in the next lecture we will see what are the probable defects in this telescope and how we can rectify that. These telescopes were made right from the time of Galileo. Galileo made these telescopes, after that Newton made these telescopes, because everybody was studying how the stars are moving. Unless Galileo would have made a telescope, there was no advance of science, whether it is astronomy, whether it is law of gravitation, anything. Everything started with a small toy telescope made by Galileo. Galilean telescope was slightly different. He was using a convex and a concave lens. Newtonian telescope is using both the convex lenses. But here, when we see the image is upside down here. So image is always upside down, but it does not make any difference to us. There is a way to convert this image in the erect image. This is objective and this is eyepiece. This distance, we insert a lens over here. This lens is such that this distance is more than the 4 times of the focal length of this lens. Distance between the two should be larger than 4f. Now, this makes this image. This image is inverted by this lens, because here is the image and this goes like this, and here image is formed. Now it is seeing this image as large image here. This the one which is making at the bottom, now that will make at that point if we make this inverted to erect. And how do we do this? By putting a lens in between. So this is how we can make inverted image to an erect image. It will appear erect. But normally we don't do this. Why we don't do this? In case of astronomy, if we are doing this, we say that we can see the star upside down. But in case in the terms of stars and earth, there is nothing as upside down. There is no upside, there is no downside. And what we are more interested is the details of the star, details of the planet, whether it appears like this or this, we don't know, because 12 hours we remain like this. Next 12 hours, we ourselves become like this. So, there is nothing as upside downside when we are rotating with the earth. Our meaning of upside and downside keeps on changing. So, that is immaterial. Other thing is, for the terrestrial things, terrestrial on the surface of the earth, we have a habit to see the things upside. And we don't want them inverted, so we will not be able to guess the things correctly. So we want everything should look erected. So if we have to use it on the earth, we are using it this way. Either this way, or we put a prism on the way which will invert it by total internal reflection. So this we can say, this is terrestrial. This is astronomical telescope. This is terrestrial telescope by fitting a lens for inversion. And there is one Galilean telescope which was using this and this. There was one concave lens. So this was Galilean telescope. So these are the three types of telescopes which are made with help of lenses. In the next lecture we will see what are the problems with the lens type of telescopes and how these can be rectified. Thank you.